What's up, my fellow beautiful people? Today, I'm gonna discuss something which I know will be very interesting because it is all about, drumroll please, animal reproduction! And the animal that I chose is the desert jasmine with the lizard, which species are called Nemidophorus uniparous. I hope I got that right.
What is that?
They are long and slender type of lizards with pointed snouts and extremely long tails. Their color tends to be tan, olive or brown with lighter stripes and or spots of yellow or white. They might sound huge, but they are actually relatively small, whose size ranges from 6.9 centimeters to 13.3 centimeters. They belong to the class of Reptilia, family of Teridae, and phyla of Chordates. I found out that this species doesn't need males to reproduce. How interesting is that? And how is that even possible? Males do not exist in this parthenogenetic species. Well, that kind of explains why they don't need males to reproduce. But how is it done? You might be thinking that they are asexual. Well, yes, they are. The lizards reproduce by parthenogenesis. It is a form of reproduction in which an egg can develop into an embryo without being fertilized by a sperm. But the offspring are not necessarily clones of their mother. This reproductive method enables the asexual desert grassland reptile lizard, well that's long, to have a genetic diversity previously thought to have been unique to sexually reproductive species. With this method, some female reptile lizards have learned to be the man, literally in their relationships in order to reproduce. Well, basically, one female gets on top of the other female and stimulates this female by pretending to be a man. And this action stimulates the lizard into fertilizing its eggs. Researchers have found that some all-female hybrid clones actually go through the same motions as the males of the sexual variety, gripping a fellow female by the neck and then by the pelvic region. And as written by David Cruz in Scientific American in 1987, the only difference between pseudo-copulation and true copulation is that the unisexual lizards are morphologically... The only difference between pseudo-copulation and true copulation is that the unisexual lizards are morphologically female, which means that they lack hemipenes, or the male reproductive system, in reptiles. And because of that, intromission cannot occur between them. And if you're gonna ask me what intromission means, it is the action or process of inserting the male genitalia into the female genitalia in sexual intercourse. So why do they do it? Apparently, the pseudo-sex is critical for ovarian development, and females in different periods of their ovarian cycle will develop male-like behavior at different times. And again, Chris said that by alternating sex roles, they maximize fecundity and increase the efficiency of reproduction. I hope you all learned something new today. Thank you for listening, and let's keep on learning.